Hello friends, welcome to Novation. I'm Shantanu, and in this lecture we are going to attempt some of the good questions on mixtures and alligations topic, which is a very important topic in quantitative ability section of all the important MBA examination like CAT, SAT, IIFT, SNAP and NMAT. So guys, do attempt the questions along with me, and in between I'll give you some assignment questions also जो कि आप खुद से ट्राई करेंगे एंड मुझे आंसर्स कमेंट सेक्शन में बताएंगे. ओके फ्रेंड्स, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस सेशन. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, अ कंटेनर कंटेन्स 40 लीटर ऑफ मिल्क. फ्रॉम दिस कंटेनर 4 लीटर ऑफ मिल्क वॉज टेकन आउट एंड रिप्लेस्ड बाय वाटर. सो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर डूइंग अ प्रोसीजर टेकिंग आउट मिल्क एंड एडिंग वाटर इन प्लेस ऑफ इट. This process was repeated further 2 times. Okay, so total number of times that we are doing this procedure is n is equals to 3 times. Okay, how much milk is now contained by the container? Okay, after doing this procedure 3 times, how much milk is left? So friends, these are certain standard question in which we use direct formula approach, which is very easy. So I'll tell you the direct formula because we need to save time, so we'll do it with direct formula. Agar friends, we have a quantity x of certain kind of liquid with us, and we are removing y liter from it and adding in another solution of y liter like we are doing in this case. So the final concentration of our first mixture will be given by x into 1 minus y by x to the power n, where n is the number of times the process is being repeated. So here we are asked to find out how much milk is now contained by the container. So our final value of milk will be, let's say it is f. Now initial value of milk is 40, and then y. What is y? We are taking out 4 liters of milk, so y is the quantity which is being removed. Okay, so 1 minus 4 by an x we know is 40. Now n, as we know, n is 3. Why it is 3 friends? Because the process was repeated 2 times. So first it was done, and then again twice it was repeated. So total number of times is n is equals to 3. Now we can quickly calculate it. F is equals to 40 into 1 minus 1 upon this will be 1 upon 10, and this will be 9 by 10 the power 3. Now what will this be? This will be this, and it will be 81 into 9, that is 729. So our final answers comes out to be will be 1 upon 25 into 729. Okay friends, now if you'll calculate it, this will come out to be 29.16. so this is the final quantity of milk that is available in the mixture after completing this process for 3 times. So our answer is 29.16. so friends, do remember this formula, very important. You can directly apply it in various cases. Okay, this formula is derived using the concept of compounding, but we need not go into that much details. You need to remember this formula. Okay, let's move forward to the next question. The next question is, 8 liters are drawn from a cask full of wine and is then filled with water. Okay, so there is a cask which is full of wine, and then 8 liters are drawn from it, and in place of it we are adding water. So does it sound similar to the previous question that we have done? Yes, of course. This operation is now performed 3 more times. Okay, so here n is equals to 4. 3 more times, the ratio of the quantity of wine now left in the cask to that of water is 16:65. Okay, so what we are given instead of the quantity which is left after completing the operations, we are given the ratio of wine that is left with respect to water, which is 16:65. How much wine did the cask originally hold? So friends, in the previous question we were asked what will be the remaining quantity. Here we are asked what is the initial quantity. Okay, so apply the same formula which we had which I showed you in the previous question, and do this and tell me the answer in the comment section. So this is your first assignment question. Friends, do it, because this problem is completely similar to the previous one. That's why I'm giving it in the assignment. So do the question and put your answer in the comment section. Then I'll tell you the answers. Let's move forward. Tea worth rupees 126 per kg and 135 kg are mixed with a third variety of tea in the ratio 1:1:2. So friends, there are three types of tea. First is 126 per kg. Second is 135 per kg. Okay, let's name this one. This is two. And now they are mixed in a variety. They are mixed in the ratio 1:1:2. Okay, if the mixture is worth rupees 153, what is the price of the third variety or third variety per kg? So friends, we are asked to find the price of third variety. Such types of questions are very easy. We just need to apply the concept of weights. So let's say that the third variety cost per kg is X. Okay. Now applying the concept of weights, as I told you, we have the final price is given to us. So 153 is equals to 126 will be multiplied by its weight, that is 1 plus 135 is to be multiplied by its weight, that is again 1 plus the third, whose price is unknown, will take it as X, and its weight is, from the ratio we see, it is 2. Now the total weights are 1 plus 1 plus 2, that is 4. Okay, now we will do quickly the calculations and find the value of X. So it will be, let's see, 153 into 4 will be 612. This will be 126 only. This will be 135 plus twice of X. Now here the sum, if we do it quickly, it will be 261 plus 2X. Now subtracting it from 612, we will get is 351 equals to twice of X. So X will be equal to 351 divided by 2, which is 175.5. So friends, we have got our answer as C, 175.5, which is the cost price of the third variety of tea. Okay, so such questions, we do it by the method of assigning weights to the cost price. So I hope the concept is clear. Let's move forward. A milk vendor has two cans of milk. The first contains 25% water and the rest is milk. The second contains 50% water. So friends, do listen to it carefully. We have first can, we have second can. Okay, and the first can contains 25% of water and the rest is milk, and the second contains 50% water and 50% milk. Okay, now how much milk should we mix from each of the container so as to get 12 liter of milk, such that the ratio of water is to milk is 3:5. Now friends, from both these can, he need to take out certain amount of mixture so that his total value is 12 liter and the ratio will be 3:5. So friends, let's say from first first can, he takes out X liter of milk. Now, in order to make the total quantity as 12 liter, he need to take out 12 minus X liter from the second can. I hope you agree. Now, what the question is saying, that first contains 25% water and rest is milk. So we'll divide two categories. From X, water will be how much? Water is going to be 1 by 4 of X, that is 25%. So 25% is represented as 1 by 4. And milk is 75%, so it will be 3/4 of X. Similarly, for the second can, we can say that since both water and milk are in same quantity, they are half-half. Okay, so it will be water is equals to 1 upon 2, 12 minus X. And similarly, milk will be 1 upon 2, 12 minus X. This is minus. Okay. Now, what are we given? The third information is that the ratio of water to milk, that is water to milk, is equals to 3:5. Now friends, let's see since these two things are mixed, this one and this one, we will just add them up. Okay, so adding, let's see what we'll get. 1 upon 4x plus 6, I'm just dividing it with 2, minus x by 2. This is the quantity of water, and the quantity of milk will come in the denominator. It will be 3 by 4 of x plus 6 minus x by 2. And this ratio, we know it is 3 by 5. So let's solve it. So here what we see is 6 minus x by 4 divided by, it will be, this is going to be x by 4 plus 6 is equal to 3 by 5. Let's solve it further. 24 minus x upon x plus 24 is equal to 3 by 5. It will be equals to 120 minus 5x equals to 3x plus, it is 72, yes. So here we get is 8x is equals to, now when 120 is subtracted from 72, what we get is 48. So x is equals to 8, 6 is 48, x is equals to 6. So friends, what we get is that from first can we are taking 6 liter, and from here 12 minus 6 equals to 6 liter. So from both the cans we are taking 6 liters. So my answer must be C, 6,6. Okay, I hope the solution is clear. Let's move forward. Two vessels A and B contains spirit and water in the ratio 5:2. So this is my first container, this is my second container. Find the ratio in which these mixture be mixed to obtain a new vessel, mixture in vessel C containing spirit and water in the ratio 8:5. So this is my final third mixture. Friends, in this such type of questions, we need to apply the concept of allegations, which is a very, very important part. So I hope you guys will understand it carefully. What allegation says is, if we take the price of a cheaper quantity, cheaper good here, cheaper good price, and if I write here the price of dearer good, what is these goods? A dearer good means whose price is higher, and cheaper good whose price is lower. This is only the difference. And here we write the mean of these prices, which is M. Let's take it as M, let's take it as C, and let's take it as D. So what we get here is D minus M upon M, M minus C. So we get these. So this is how you need to write while making an allegation. Now these values, D minus M upon M minus C is equals to the, it will be equal to the quantity of cheaper good upon the quantity of dearer good. So this is the final ratio which comes out of allegation. We are going to make use of this concept only. So first of all, we are given the spirit and water ratio is 5:2 for the first vessel. So out of it, let's take the ratio of spirit only. Okay, so what will be the quantity of spirits in terms of ratio? It will be 5:7. Okay, so here we'll write 5:7. Similarly, from here, what will the total ratio of spirit when considering it as a complete solution? It will be 7:13. Now here, what we are getting is the final average is this, that is 8:5 is the ratio of spirit and water. So what is the total ratio of spirit when considering it as a whole solution? It will be 8:13. Now let's apply our concept of allegation which we have learned right now. This will be subtracting this from this, which will be 1:13. And if we are subtracting this from this, this time we're going to subtract this from this. So 5:7 minus 8:13. Okay, so now what we are going to get is 65 minus 856 upon 91. This will be equal to 5 plus 4 is 9 by 91. Similarly, what we are getting is 1 upon 13 here, and we are getting 9 by 91 here. Okay, so what we know is that this ratio, that is 1 upon 13 upon 9 by 91, will give us the ratio of the quantity of this. What we have taken here is spirit in A upon quantity of spirit in B. So what we are getting, the final ratio is this, 7 upon 9. So friends, the ratio in which these mixture we mixed in order to obtain a new mixture is in C is this, 7:9. So if I mix these first and second vessels in the ratio of 7:9, I'm going to get this 8:5 as my final mixture. So I hope the method is clear. I recommend that you go and practice more and more questions about alligations. So this will make much more clear how alligation is applied. Okay, it's a very, very easy concept. Just you need to practice a little bit so that you can easily understand which question you need to apply alligations. Okay, so let's move forward. Now the next question is, a vessel is filled with liquid, 3 parts of which are water, 5 parts are syrup. So initially what we have is water is to syrup is equals to 3:5. How much of the mixture must be drawn off and replaced with water so that the mixture may be half water and half syrup? Finally, the mixture is 1:1 because both are same, the quantity will be same finally after we take out certain amount of mixture and replace it with certain that same amount of water. So let's say initially water is 3x and our syrup is 5x, which gives us the total quantity as 8x initially. Now let's say I'm taking out y units of mixture. So what I'll get is water will remain as 3x minus y. How much of water will go out from this? It will be 3/8, and we are going to add the same amount of water, that is y. How the total mixture that we are taking out, we are adding it back in the form of water. Now syrup, 5x minus 5/8 of y, this much syrup will be left finally. Now friends, we are given that finally this ratio will be 1:1. So what we can say is 3x plus y minus 3/8y upon 5x minus 5y/8 equals to 1/1. Simply cross multiplying and equating them, what I'm going to get is 3x minus, I'm converting it, so it will be 5y/8 is equals to 5x minus 5y/8. Okay, this is plus. So what we are going to get here is 10y/8 is equals to 2x. What we get is y is equals to 8x/5. Okay, so what we have been asked is how much of the mixture must be drawn off, and the options are in ratio. So friends, 8x is the initial quantity that I told you, 8x. So what we are taking out is 1/5 of the initial quantity. So my answer must be C, 1/5. Okay, I hope you're getting the point. So let's move forward to the next question. Next is, a merchant has 1000 kg of sugar, part of which he sells at 8% profit and rest at 18% profit. Okay, so one part of it, let's say he is selling at this part is x, so this will be 1000 minus x, which he is selling at 18% profit. He gains 14% on the whole. Okay, the quantity sold at 18% profit is. So friends, again we are going to use alligations, a very, very, very common question of alligation. Let's see how we are going to apply it. First of all, do not ever think that allegation can be applied only in the case of price. Allegation can be used even in time and distance question, even in profit and loss question. Okay, so let's see this. First of all, I'm going to write 8% profit here and here 18% profit. And the quantity here is X and it is 1000 minus X. Okay. Now, as a whole, on an average, what we are getting is the profit that we are getting is 14%. Okay. Now, as we know from allegation, I'm going to subtract this from here and put it here. It will be 4. And here, I'm going to subtract here. And I'm going to write it here. It will be 6. So my ratio is 2 upon 3 is equals to the quantity that we have, X upon 1000 minus X. 3x is equals to 2000 minus 2x. Here we get 5x is equals to 2000. X is equals to 400. Okay, so what we have been what we have to determine is the quantity sold at 18%. 18% per hum kya sell kar rahe hain? 1000 minus X. So my quantity is 1000 minus 400. My answer is 600. Okay, so C, 600 is my answer. So I hope you're understanding how allegation is getting applied in such type of questions also. Let's move forward. So friends, the next question is, a dishonest milkman sells his milk at cost price, but he mixes it with water and thereby gains 25%. What is the percentage of water in the mixture? So friends, what we see here is that there is a dishonest milkman and he's selling his milk at cost price and still he's gaining 25%. Why? Because he's adding milk with water. So friends, let's say the cost price is 1 and he's selling it at selling price 1 also, but then there is no profit. So what actually is happening is, even though the cost price is 1, his effective cost price is not 1. It is something very less. So let's say the effective cost price is X and we find out what is this X. Even though 1 is the cost price, he's not actually has to spend 1 rupees because he's adding milk to it. Okay, I hope you're understanding why I'm telling that X will be something less than 1. Let's find out by using the formula for gain. So it will be selling price minus X upon X, which will be equal to 1 upon 4, which is 25%. Selling price is 1 minus X upon X equals to 1 upon 4. 4 minus 4X is equals to X, which is equals to 5X equals to 4. X equals to 4 by 5. So friends, his actual cost price is 4 upon 5. So that's why he is able to sell it at 1 rupee. Okay, so he's not facing this cost price, which is 1 rupees, which should have been the cost price, which he is not taking that cost price because he is adding milk to it. Now what we are asked is, what is the percentage of water in the mixture? So guys, we have to find out how much water is he adding in that very mixture. Okay, so let's use allegation to find out. Now for here we are going to take milk. And here we are going to take water. So the cost price for milk is, actual cost price is 1. And the actual cost price for water is, of course, 0. Water is, we consider it as, it is freely available for him. And when he mixes it, his actual cost price becomes 4 by 5. Now from allegation, I'm going to subtract it, 4 upon 5. And here it is going to be 1 upon 5. Okay. So what we have asked is, what is the percentage of water in the mixture? Now what how we are going to determine is the quantity of water ratio of quantity of water upon the ratio of quantity of milk is equals to 1 by 5, which is this, divided by 4 by 5. Okay, so this will be 1 by 4. So this is the quantity of milk, quantity of water upon quantity of milk. Now if I want, what is the percentage of water in the whole mixture? So what I'll have to do is QW upon QW plus Q qm. I have to take whole of mixture in the denominator. So what will happen is it will be 1 upon 1 plus 4, which will be equals to 1 upon 5. Now I'm simply going to take the percentage, which is equals to 20%. So my answer should be 20%. He is adding 20% of water in the mixture. So I hope, friends, this concept is clear, because such kind of questions are too often asked in various competitive exams like CAT, XAT and IIFT. So this is very, very important for you to understand this concept. Okay, now let's move forward. In what ratio must water be mixed with milk to gain 16 2 by 3, that is 16 2 by 3% on selling the mixture at cost price? Okay, so friends, again, this is the same type of question that we have done again, done the previous one. So I give this question also as your assignment question. So please attempt this one and the previous one that I have asked you to do. Do comment your answers in the comment section, then I'll tell you the answers. Okay, so please attempt these questions. And now this is the end of the session. I hope this was fruitful. So thanks a lot for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to Novation for more awesome content. All the best. Bye bye.